two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. Scott on the return out of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they're down on the scoreboard, sort of a sloppy first half. Coach Davis, if you were in the locker room, what would the message have been?
I think I'd have to go with something you don't ordinarily go with in the NFL. That's a fire and brimstone. You've got to fire these guys up, make them understand what's going on out there. They were so sloppy in the first half, too many turnovers. Tighten things up, maybe get in their face a little bit, get in their grill, and then send them back out.
Second and two. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and four coming up. They'll look to throw here. And Sanders has got it complete. And he'll get nothing out of that one. So he stopped for no gain. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
So that'll back him up five. And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and nine. Try and throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out, and the Colts are going to get the football in outstanding field position. Get this off in time. Yeah, that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. Backs him up five, first and 15.
Snap coming at one. Now Wentz. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
But defensively, you're over there trying to catch your breath and try not to show the offense that you're a little bit fatigued. You're right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long field goal situation.
Again, the play clock's going to run out on him, and that'll set him back five.
Here we go, D, get off the field.
Wentz to throw on second down. He's got his target. That's Zach Pascal. 17 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
And he is going to have a Colts first down. They needed 3. He doubled that. He got 6.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Here's Taylor. And he's going to work this one down to about the 5. 50 yards on the ground for him so far.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. On the handoff, Taylor. A good display of power, but ultimately it gets him just inside the 5 to the 4 and no further. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and 2. To throw is Wentz. Eluding the pressure right. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Zach Pascal there to make the grab. And the Colts are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. Now Blankenship on for the PAT. It is now 21-0. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Scott on the return, out of the end zone. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Throwing again on second and 10. Hurts airing it out deep for Smith. And got his man complete. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. A big play that time through the air. 45 yards. Before they can snap it, time runs out on this third quarter of play. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. First and 10, it's Sanders. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. They follow up that gigantic gain with the tiniest of pickups, 1 yard.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Here's Hurts to throw. It's caught, Smith. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts' 12-yard line. Throwing is Hurts. Left side here to Sanders. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line. Second and 4. They can still get a first down without scoring. They go back to the ground with Sanders. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles are finally on the board here in the fourth quarter. Now that Eagle offense will stay out there as they'll go for 2. They'll turn to Sanders. But he will find the end zone again. So he gets the touchdown and the 2-point conversion. And that'll cut this deficit down a little bit further. Two scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And Taylor, I don't think he got there. No, he did not. Unable to break free, and he's marked short. He needed two. He got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard. And he's not going to get there. Might have even lost a yard. He only needed a yard, but he couldn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. And the Eagles defense able to hold. First and 10, it's Hurts. Throw right side, caught by Goddard, the tight end. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. This is complete to Watkins on the slant. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll get it with just a shade under a minute to go in the game. First down, Hurts. And one more time, that's Watkins. A gain of six there on first. From the 27, Hurts. Flush to his right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Watkins. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. 7 yards the pick up there. Looking to throw again on second down. Hurts. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. Yeah, the Eagles are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. The Eagles will take their third and and final timeout as they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game. Sets up to throw it. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left.
A lot of practice time, a lot of thinking goes into two-minute drills, even on the defensive side. So now you want to make sure the guys understand. Continue to be aggressive, but make sure you're smart in doing so.
Second and goal. Hurts. And he's going to go down. Sacked right around the 17. In on the sack, the former.